representative of the governor of Kisumu. The other county chief executive in charge of lands from Goma. All the wonderful men and women here, for want of time, allow me to see in the Kenyan style all protocols observed. And because I may not be able to greet each one of you by hand, can we greet each other in the air like this? Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure really, to join you during this occasion. I feel honored and humbled to address you. I hope I'm not going to miss my flight. I'm also happy to have with me participants from the ministry, as was mentioned earlier on. And I'm informed that this conference has attracted people from far and wide, which is good, from our neighboring countries, Tanzania, Uganda, Ethiopia, Eritrea, and Djibouti. And therefore, really take this opportunity to welcome all of you to this nation. I also want to appreciate the initiative made by ESLI East Africa in organizing this conference. And I'm handing my chorus to whatever others have said. And it did to give me an opportunity to come and learn and to meet other people as you share your experiences in GIS world. And the lady was here. I thought she was very passionate about our work and our good brother, also this gentleman. Can you clap for them, please? Your passion means a lot of things. Eh? If you love something, you can do great things because of passion, the drive, yeah, the drive about what you do. I understand, we all know that ESRI is a global leader in GIS and has been tirelessly developing tools. I've noticed that actually, that help has to discover, and as was mentioned, not only to discover, but to use, make, and share maps. We talked about location, share maps from any digital device. I think that's been very important. Any digital device at any time, anywhere. I like that. Irrespective of our individual organization roles. It could be small, it could be big, it could be a manager, all of us. In other words, whether as executives, as professionals, one is able to apply the GIS and GIS tools that have been so ably presented a few minutes ago. Geographic Information System, GIS, is a powerful technology, as we have been told, that enables each one of us to look at the geospatial location differently from the way we have always done, and be able to answer the question, what happens where? Considering that everything happens somewhere. If there's going to be a flood, a mudslide, or a landslide somewhere, is it possible to use GIS? And the answer is yes. We know where it is. It's very easy. And if somebody, as we have been told, is complaining about power outages, it's very easy to locate where they are. Again, using GIS. Making our work extremely easy, very efficient, very effective. And it's one thing to know of a system, of a platform, of tools. It's one thing to know and another to apply. And the greatest challenge to many of us is the application bit. We keep on saying we'll do this forever. And that forever is never coming until cows come home. So my challenge is that we must do something about it. The GIS technology enables us to remotely relate different human activities, the way she has put it, that happen within neighborhoods, enabling us to address conflicting activities as well as enhance correlating human activities. This is in line with somebody's definition, somebody's law, somebody called Tobler, the law of geography. Everything is related to everything else. You did, that was wonderful pictorial presentation, I loved it. The GIS technology is developing, that we know, it's advancing and changing fast. Will you be left behind? That's the issue. For example, today we see the use of unmanned aerial vehicles, the so-called UAVs, or drones, as we hear, the use of light detection and ranging data, very high resolution set rates, name it, many things. So all of us will agree, ladies and gentlemen, that the use of computers, tablets, and smartphones are on the rise. And if they are on the rise, we must use them productively, especially for the purposes that we have been told. On one hand, governments are now fast-tracking computerization of information systems and are able to use GIS to enhance revenue collection and service delivery. Is it possible to collect stamp duty, for example, faster? The answer is yes. Having listened to what I've heard, it can be done. And this is exactly what we want to do. When you talk about the ease of doing business, if you are talking about the time taken to perform certain procedures or to be involved in certain activities, and I think GIS does helps us do that, even make things faster, yeah, at a short notice. The developers and programmers, on the other hand, like S3 East Africa, are creating intuitive, interactive, and user-friendly applications. You have heard about automated workflows, as well as very powerful tools that simplify complex processes. And sometimes you can be bogged down thinking about the complexity of matters, but they have been made easy. I assure all of you that for effective and efficient decision making, ladies and gentlemen, not only decision making, but even planning, development, and management of our resources, we should be able to say, yes, we have waters here, we have sources of power, we have minerals, we have bios. First of all, where are they? We need to map them, isn't it? We need to know where they are. And that is not enough. We need to plan. When you talk about your special plan, we've been talking about this for quite some time. But it's going to be the reality. It's going to be the reality. Yeah? So, again, thanks to GIS, we have to bring all these layers of information together so as to have, as was mentioned, an integrated view and understand our world. Today, we are living in a global village. We hear this very often. And we must be able to relate and plan our activities. Because this world, ladies and gentlemen, is not expanding. And as somebody said, it's an inelastic and static space. So that space must be used in a way which is of benefit to all of us. And for that to happen, my challenge is what I said earlier on. Let us invest in technology. You can go and buy a piece of land in Kitengela, there is no harm. Or even in Kisumu City. But then you can do better if you invest in technology. Because you can do things better, more efficiently, and earn more money. So that you can buy more plots of land. Eh? And this is the truth. This is the truth, ladies and gentlemen. All what I've said here encourages a high level of collaboration in the execution of our duties. It's collaborative effort at all levels, so that we're able to do that which we must do. I know that DESRI East Africa has a module package for organizations, such as an enterprise systems package, whose demand by institutions has been on the rise, so I understand. And this kind of arrangement enables realization of one authoritative data source. And we need that in this country and as well. Unified workflows and systems integration. While a national special data infrastructure, such as the one we have, the Kenya National Special Data Infrastructure, can spur the socioeconomic growth of the nation by taming duplication of geospatial data collection. We need to tame duplication. And this is where collaborative effort is very important. And sometimes people talk and wonder whether they come from the same country. And it's because their efforts are not integrated. That's the challenge to all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, I do reiterate that the need for effective and efficient service delivery is critical. Timely responses to emergency issues, both man-made and national. timely responses. And for us to do that, we need to do what our sister told us a few minutes ago, whether it is regard to boundary conflicts, and we have them in the country. Can we be able to spot there's a boundary conflict in Meru, between the Merus and other people, PCs and you know what I mean? Can we be able to detect and move quickly? And I'm up to the, again, the people from the national government are here, the deputy commissioners. Yeah, so that we can be able to do these things quickly. So that when we send a rescue mission, it is timely, very efficient. And again, can't you say, this technology. So I understand, really, this, I understand has prompted the industries and government reach to research on better ways to engage with their customers and citizens respectively. We must also bear in mind that it is a constitutional obligation that even as we do all these wonderful things, the public must be informed. Public participation is a constitutional mandate. And sometimes you wonder whether we do things where the left hand doesn't know what the right hand is doing. It can happen, remember that. So I'm happy to say that indeed, my ministry has embraced GIS technology and is implementing its use in all directories and departments. Why can't you clap for us? What is the problem? So I also have passion, like my sister here, and I have passion for this. Because it makes a difference. Yes, I have passion for it. So you have a convertee and a good one. You can be sure. What I would say is that we need to be ambassadors. We need to be ambassadors, all of us, for this technology. And using this technology, we have been able, for example, to map our activities, including data collection, data management, and map production. In the year 2013, those of us who are not Kenyans, we were able to set up something called National Titling Center. And with a goal of producing 3 million titles each in three years period. And to date, I'm happy to announce that we have produced more than 2.4 million titles. And because of that center, we are able to produce, we have the capacity to produce 15,000 titles per day. That's great, isn't it?
Yes.
So we cannot complain and say that, yes, we have brought all this information expeditiously. We're not able to process this. We are going to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, the entire duration of this conference, I believe there will be a lot of experience sharing amongst all of us. I mentioned this somewhere, that we learn every day. And there are times when you think the experience that you have is insurmountable. Yet when you listen to others, it's made very easy, isn't it? Very easy. And let us invest in these things, please. Let us invest in a big way. Don't ever imagine attending a conference is a waste of time. It is never. I'm told for some strange reason, this place is full. Whatever reason. I don't know whether you love Kisumu City, but I want to encourage you to maintain the same spirit. So that even when there are conferences out of this country, whether in America or not, let us spend some money and go there. We will learn a lot. Of course, as you leave, very easy for some of us, even those who are under pressure to leave. If you can come, find some time, come back again and learn what this makes this country tick. Because you have wonderful places for you to see. Kenya is a great country. Just come. All right? With all these many remarks, and there are many, not like a politician. Mine is wish you a beautiful deliberations. Have fun, share, learn more, and aim at making a world a better place to live. Make a difference. Don't be a mere statistic. It's very easy for people to come and say, yes, you came and disappeared. We want when you are 6 feet under somewhere, one day, we shall say you made a difference in the other people's lives. particularly the poor, the marginalized, people who are not as gifted as you are. If you can do that, you are coming to this world, it shall not be in vain. It was many remarks now. It's my present duty and honor to thank you once again for listening to me. Thank you and God bless you.
Tanzania.
Yes, we have an office in your work in Tanzania as well.
Wonderful. Make sure that things are running well there.
Yes.
So, yes, what does Harmonion do? How are you?
Pleasure. Hi.
Fine.
Yeah, we are a solutions, end-to-end solutions company.
Yeah.
So we are ESRI implementers, so we do consultancy, application development, systems integration, the entire database creation, all of that. And also we build all the solutions. So we do all the 3D city modeling, we build applications around it. For tourism, for urban planning, for development, carbon schemes, monitoring. We have lots of solutions, vertical solutions that we build. Even for emergency management, we have built a lot of solutions. So for planning and preparedness, so we're actually a US-based company.
Okay.
We're finishing 25 years.
How soon do you intend to make your presence here be felt?
Sorry?
How soon do you want to make your presence be felt here? Because you're US-based.
Yes. But we are looking to do that. So I'm coming from the Indian office.
Yeah.
And so the US is a headquarter and we have offices in Europe. Mm. But we look forward to being here. This is our first visit.
Our first visit here.
Really?
First time here.
Yeah. So we thought.
We landed yesterday evening.
Welcome.
And yeah, it's a pleasure. It's been really nice. And we look forward to, you know, experience everything. This was it, and then hopefully be here locally also.
Good.
So hopefully that'll be soon in answer to your question.
I'm just wondering how much you've helped the Indian company.
Oh, quite a lot. Actually, yeah, we're doing quite a lot in the urban planning.
Let's talk about that sector. You know, my interest is land.
Yeah. So we're doing a lot in the urban planning and development side. So in one of the states down in the south, Karnataka, the city of Mysore, we've done a complete workbook for the planners. It's a GIS, but more details for the solutions.
Good.
That does all of that, yeah.
I was in Karnataka.
Oh, you were? Okay, that's Mysore is right there.
I did my master's degree there.
Yeah. Oh, very nice.
Yes. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Yeah, so what makes the Ramani tick? Yes, yeah.
Mm. Ramani is an aerial survey mapping company.
Yeah.
Yes, and we've been involved in the mapping for the main landmark project, like the standard gauge railway. So we come before the construction.
Oh, yeah. What is unique about aerial surveys? What is unique as opposed to conventional type of survey?
Well, because it is very ideal for capturing detailed survey data for very large areas. You can imagine surveying the standard gauge railway 1,000 kilometers by land.
It's faster,
we would never achieve our goals.
Yeah, it's faster.
A lot faster, a lot more accurate.
Very more accurate, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that is a bit we need to emphasize.
Exactly.
Accuracy,
faster.
Yeah.
Cheaper.
Right. Thank you.
All right, Karibu.
Yes, Cortex systems and
solutions.
Yes,
indeed.
Mm. How are you doing? Salama.
Very fine, thank you.
Yeah.
So we do enterprise solutions, mm-hmm. and we are the team who have done the National Lands Information System that was recently launched by yourself. You remember you were there.
You're the people who have done this, yeah,
yes.
Of course. Yeah, I remember what it is.
Indeed. And we are bringing in GIS to the enterprise across the entire government and also other areas. Also, apart from NLC, we've also done National Construction Authority system, where we are mapping in terms of regulation and compliance of construction across Kenya, linking it with GIS.
Oh.
So we are also here as partners.
That would be nice, yeah? Not
yes.
Construction compliance.
Exactly.
Yeah?
Yes, it was launched and that we're operational, but we have mobile applications, and those inspectors going around are able to take photographs of buildings that are under construction, those ones who are compliant, those ones who are not, and all that information is seen at the headquarters in Nairobi. Apart from that, also, we are doing the...
So you think because of this solution, we have improved
compliance
in construction?
Exactly.
We are not using certificates,
no,
for example,
sir.
Occupation, just like that.
And we are able to find out, come in the vendors who are compliant and those who are not, by the regions.
Yeah.
Using the GIS, of course. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right. Yes, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Very good, very good. Yes.
My name is
how are you, brother? Yes.
Mad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As a proud sponsor, so what do you do?
Trimble. Mm-hmm. We deal with landscape products and GIS products.
Yeah.
Our company name is Octon. Mm-hmm. Octon is a distributor of Trimble products in Eastern Africa.
Yeah.
Our industry office is based in Nairobi, right now here. This is one of our total stations that we use in landscape. This is our GPS.
I hope we have all this equipment. We have.
We have all this equipment.
No, I'm talking about just as a ministry.
Yes, we have.
Where is Zimbabwe? We have all this armor.
Yes, we have. This is one we provide.
We don't use your own equipment.
Yes, we have supplied. Yeah. We're actually in about 9 counties now.
Yeah.
Also using our equipment.
Oh, fantastic. 9 counties.
9 counties have our equipment.
What are the challenges for the other counties? Not
the challenges for the counties, we find finance. Equipment is a bit costly,
yeah.
And they have to plan towards getting it.
Why don't you make plans to make it easy for them to?
We are working with that.
Access.
We are access.
Yeah, I'm not
the
saying.
The county should also go on higher parking system.
That's what I'm saying. You have to think of ways outside the box, so that you can make sure that they acquire. Because this equipment is good.
Yes.
It's the latest, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Even as we plan, we plan for our cities and towns, to plan well, we have the latest equipment, isn't it?
Yes.
Good. Yeah, thank you very much. And what is this gadget?
These are the hardware. These are the GIS. So the handheld for GIS. They have different accuracies.
Yeah.
This one gives 1 to 2 meters accuracy.
Mm.
This one gives 3 to 5 meters accuracy. This one gives sub-meter accuracy.
The people, do you now, as a company, by any chance, do you train some people for short courses, capacity building? Do you do that?
We do offer trainings with when we supply our services. We go the whole lot. We make sure everyone who has purchased our equipment is fully trained. We train for
correct.
Our services.
Yeah. Yeah. So serviceability is not an issue.
Yes, and then from our office,
S3 are distributed.
Oh.
The service products.
Why is it? Welcome. Yes?
It's also a
how are you? What kind of services? What are we doing?
Yes,
how are you, my brother?
Special solutions. Mm. And we also provide survey of Kenya. We have actually been working with survey of Kenya.
That center of ours.
Yes,
that center of ours. Are you?
Yes.
Are you?
Huh? Yeah, we have actually worked together to provide the equipment and set up the place for map production.
Yeah, because the most important thing in your administration there is repairs. You want to make sure that your equipment, that people are heavily there.
Yes.
There was a time when very nasty enlightenment in the sense that you want something repaired.
Yeah.
Eh? You must go to Britain or Germany and bring somebody to come and do that.
Luckily, we're able to.
You're able to do that?
Yes, we're able to support them.
And in terms of repairs, it's not an issue. Yeah, it's fair, but, sir?
Yes.
Good.
And the press wanted you to look at this.
What is it meant to do? This one, the other way around.
It's a digital level, so you use it. You put it on.
Yeah, that's better.
So you use it for finding levels, construction zones, and also.
Instead of being the issue of money, you use the story so much.
I understand.
Yes, Elasa, Emalani. The same?
No, we have our original center for us.
This one.
This one is covered.
Hi, bro.
How are you?
Of course, you know this one.
Yeah. Mambo Gwaji.
Assalamu.
Yeah?
So this is the original center for Mapu.
Yes.
And this is dealing with mapping of resources for development.
Oh, mapping of resources.
Yeah. You know, governmental.
Yeah. You remember one of the biggest challenges, of course, is that mapping of resources.
Yeah.
And I think economy of national data for all these resources.
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense.
Yeah,
you do. You can plan them for them better. Somebody was talking about avoiding duplication, and I agree. Duplicative efforts. Asante sana. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
This is our new partner.
Yeah.
Kasif and Alami.
Yes, how are you?
Alami. You are one of the Azri partners.
Yes.
And we are a platinum partner. Mm-hmm. And we operate all over the Middle East and Africa. Mm-hmm. And I have very special interest in East Africa, and we are working
closely.
And
Kenya, more of Kenya.
Yeah, it's actually
my
first time to come to Kenya, so I'm always happy coming back to Kenya.
Yeah.
So we're here showing some of
so
our...
So what do you do? What do you do actually?
We do all sorts of GIS solutions.
Yes.
And now we are showing some of the sample of things we've done. Like, we've done the census for Oman.
Yeah.
We did the census without using any paper. All using tablets and smartphones.
Really? Census?
Yeah, paperless census. Yeah. We do lots of dashboards. We do a lot of solutions for tourism, for the government. So here is like a whole, like a big range of services that can be offered in GIS.
Monitoring and service, passive building. We do a transfer. Do you need a
training? We have a training center as well.
Yeah.
We do a lot of land management, inspection, application.
Yeah.
We did even one here on the screen for land management and parcel management. Mm-hmm.
So let's take the case of parcel management. What aspects of parcel management are we talking about?
Like the ownership of the permits for digging, the merging of plots for the ownership, like now he merged all of these parts into one big plot, putting who's the owner of it. So all aspects, and we are getting also into the taxation part and revenue collection part as well.
Yeah, that's very important. To make a collection of revenue faster.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. We stop here, this is the last station.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Welcome to our stand.
Here 360, this is an interesting one, it's called Here 360 or something like that.
Yes, we are a company owned by the Japan car auto manufacturers, that is the Audi BMW in England, that's the brand for Mercedes-Benz.
Yeah.
So what we do, we power the world-based navigation solutions and in market segments, that is the automotive, like in the industry car navigation. Then we have the enterprise and we have the consumer. So part of our brand that we help power are just to mention a few what we have here. We have the Audi, at least 90% of all the in-car navigation systems. Apart from that, you also have the businesses, which includes like the Bing, the Facebook. I've told you sponsor on Facebook, we are the one who power the platform, as well as Instagram. And a number of mobile phone providers such as Samsung and iOS are still using our solution. Apart from that, we do work with a lot of other enterprise brands such as the FedEx, the Esri, part of our solutions, and as well as Amazon.
Bring the enterprise brands to us here. So you work very closely with others.
So we work with a lot of global partners, that's our team. So we provide the data for this solution.
Wonderful, wonderful. So are we with these people?
Yes, the ministry is there.
So working with the ministry.
So yes, we do provide. Actually, we use your part of the government data, like the secondary school, the primary school, to be part of our navigation. For example, if you don't know how to get to Rachoni Secondary School, probably you are not conversant with the locality.
Yeah.
You can open the application there or the in-car national application, point to the school, and to navigate your turn right hand, turn left, turn right, and turn left.
You are the people keep on singing and turn left. Yes.
You are the people that make noise.